Hello friends, welcome to this video on circles. In the previous video, we discussed about concyclic points and a theorem related to it. Today, we will solve a question based on it. So let's start. In triangle ABC, points P, Q and R are the midpoints of sides BC, CA and AB respectively, and AD is perpendicular to side BC. Then, prove that points P, Q, R and D are concyclic points. Friends, we are given that in triangle ABC, points P, Q and R are the midpoints of side BC, CA and AB respectively. So according to the midpoint theorem, line segment RP will be parallel to side AC and it will be equal to half of it, which means it will be equal to AQ, and line segment PQ will be parallel to side AB and will be equal to half of it, that is, it will be equal to RA. The opposite sides of the quadrilateral AQPR are equal and parallel, therefore it will be a parallelogram. Opposite angles of a parallelogram are equal, therefore angle QPR and angle A will be equal. Let's call it equation 1. Friends, we have to prove that points P, Q, R and D are concyclic points. If we prove that angle QPR and angle RDQ are equal, then we know that if a line segment joining two points subtends equal angles at two other points lying on the same side of the line containing the line segment, then the four points lie on a circle, that is, they are concyclic. You can pause the video and try to prove it. Point R is the midpoint of side AB and RQ is parallel to BC. So, RN will be also parallel to BD. If in triangle ABD, if we use the converse of the midpoint theorem, then we can say that point N will be the midpoint of side AD, that is, DN and AN will be equal. Friends, look at triangles ARN and DRN. AD is perpendicular to side BC. This is given to us. And as you can see in the figure, AN and D are in the same line. So AN will also be perpendicular to the line segment RQ. And angle ANR and angle DNR will be equal to 90 degrees and RN is the common side. So from equations 2, 3 and 4, we can say that triangles ARN and DRN will be congruent according to the side angle side congruence rule. And we know that the corresponding parts of congruent triangles are equal. Therefore, their corresponding angles will also be equal. That is, we can write angle RAN and angle RDN as equal. In triangle ABD, according to the angle sum property of a triangle, we can write the sum of these three angles to be equal to 180 degrees. And you can see that angle ADB is a right angle, so we can write angle BAD as 90 degrees minus angle B. Angle BAD and angle RAN are the same, that is, angle RDN, or we can say angle RDA also will be equal to 90 degrees minus angle B. Similarly, we can obtain angle QDA to be equal to 90 degrees minus angle C. Pause the video and obtain it yourselves. According to the figure, we will write angle RDQ as angle RDA plus angle QDA. And now, we will substitute the measure of angle RDA and angle QDA in this equation and simplify it like this. Friends, we know that the sum of the three interior angles of a triangle is 180 degrees. So, if from 180 degrees the sum of the measure of these two angles is subtracted, then angle A is obtained. So, in equation 8, we can write it as angle A. We got angle RDQ equal to angle A. Let's call it equation 9. Now, from equations 1 and 9, we can say that angle RDQ and angle QPR are equal. These two angles are the angles subtended by the line segment RQ on point D and point P. Therefore, we can say that points P, Q, R and D are concyclic points. Friends, that's all in today's session. Today, we solved a question based on concyclic points and a theorem related to it. See you in the next video. Thank you.